This is 36 gauge wire. It's about like trying to work with one of your hairs. When I put this in here, I took the wire from the bottom of the coil, which was the beginning, and I wrapped it around and brought it out over here. That just gives me a little extra wire to play with at some point in the future. I took the wire from the top of this coil, and I wrapped it around here a couple of times and brought it out here. So we're connecting the bottom of one coil to the top of another. You bring the wires out, take a cigarette lighter and just very quickly burn that to try and get the coating off of the wire. And I came back with some real fine emery and just stroked that on those wires until I had some shiny copper showing, and then soldered those together. And I've done that going all the way around, and I have these two wires sticking out here. I'm going to check this for continuity, verify that I have a circuit, and I do. All coils are connected together in series. I put a wood dowel across here so I'm not pushing directly on those metal rods. I'm pushing on two end caps. Since you never know for sure what you're going to need down the road, you may find a little extra wire handy. There's really nothing here to short out. So I'm just going to put a piece of tape across that little fold of wire. Hopefully that will keep that nailed down. And if I need it, I can go back here and peel the end of the tape loose. And I'll do that all the way around. So I have all the ends taped down, and I put a little more substantial wire on the last two. I'll check this again, make sure we have continuity. And we do. So all six coils are tied together in series. So this is all assembled. And I want to put the nut and washer on here. So this is right in the middle of that travel. And we're going to verify that none of the magnets are hitting those steel bars. So I put the washer and nut in there. And this is going to be right about there. I don't want to tighten that too tight. That seems to be tight enough. And this is not jiggling anymore when I turn this. And that turns freely. I've also made a cover. This is intended to make things look a little neater, but mainly to protect these coils. That goes on there like that. And I don't have any set screws. If everything works, then I will use set screws on here. We're going to fire this thing up. And we're going to see if we get any voltage out of it. Pretty out of electric, but not very much.